Good morning. I'm sure you've all bought teddy bears for your children at one point or another. A stuffed bear, the fluff, the fur, the sweet face, the sentimental value that accompanies finding the perfect one for your child. You bought them to make your child smile, because teddy bears bring happiness in our lives. For children in Philadelphia, teddy bears mean something different. On any given day, compilations of stuffed animals, candles, hand-drawn cards, withering bouquets, many other cherished moments commemorate someone's passing on many of our corners. Three stories I wanted to share with you today, three lives lost, paint the picture, the diverse picture of gun violence in the city of Philadelphia, as well as the neighborhoods in my legislative district. The first story involves a young man by the name of Bernard Scott, who was a promising ninth grade student who attended Overbrook High School. He was interested in working with his mentors and his teachers to pursue a career in engineering upon his graduation. His life was tragically cut short while standing around watching an altercation between students that ended in gun violence and him being fatally shot by accident. The second story involved another young man who stepped in between a domestic violent dispute between his female cousin and her boyfriend at the time. Several days after the altercation, the boyfriend returned and fatally shot the young man due to retaliation. The third and final story happened just days ago in my district, when a young man took his own life due to depression and the pressures of life. These three incidents tell the story not often told when discussing gun violence in urban communities. Oftentimes, the stories highlighted are those resulting from drug transactions, rival gangs, robberies, and things alike. But as you can see, these stories should require us to look at every case different and discuss the broader question of how guns get into the hands of those that make our communities unsafe and those who may be at risk of harming themselves or those that they love. When I think of these three situations and the incidents that happen on a daily basis in my city, I ask myself what laws could have been put in place to prevent these incidents from happening in the future. Recognizing there's no one thing we can do to end this type of violence, I do believe there are things we can put in place that can move us in the right direction. The story of Bernard Scott at Overbrook High School, along with many more not featured on the news, and the shooting in Parkland, Florida, intensified the need for action to protect our children. We must address the proliferation of gun violence in our schools. We have several bills that we can act on to do so, so I am in support of House Bill 2146 from Rep. Thomas, which would create an advisory committee to study the safety and security of public schools throughout the Commonwealth, as well as House Bill 2170 from Rep. Schweier to ban sales or possession of assault weapons for individuals under the age of 21. Or on domestic violence, we could enact Senate Bill 501, which would add additional protections for victims of domestic violence, which a series of my peers discussed previously. Lastly, which is bold, I believe, we could begin examining the idea of allowing local counties to develop their own gun laws with approval from the General Assembly, considering that one size does not fit all. I am a firm believer that the availability and usage of guns in urban, rural, and suburban settings are different, which will require a different approach in each setting. But as I stated before, supporting these measures won't completely eliminate and address every gun violence incident that occurs, which is something I reflect on daily. In my district, I have Overbrook Presbyterian Church in the 192nd, which I represent. There is a memorial that they do every year. This is a monument for Philadelphians murdered by guns in the past year. This year, 371 shirts were placed outside to remember those who died victims of senseless gun violence, which kills Americans every year. It carries massive consequences in lives lost, injuries, and medical treatment. But what about the economic costs in jobs, businesses, and community development? This ongoing epidemic ripples through our economy in the form of lost wages, medical bills, higher taxes for law enforcement, and lower property values, among other factors. The total annual cost of gun violence in the United States is $220 billion, including direct and indirect costs. Some estimates put the tab total even higher. According to estimates developed by the Pacific Institute for Research and Evaluation and relied on by the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, on average, each gun-related death generates approximately $49,164 in medical expenses, even more if it's a non-fatal shooting and requires hospitalization. Approximately $439,000 in police investigation and criminal justice expenses, plus the cost of incarceration. From $2,500 to $10,000 in employer costs, up to $1.7 million in lost wages, between $300,000 and $730,000 in lost business opportunities. This is at least $1 million per shooting. We could have accomplished great things with $370 million in Philadelphia. Think about it. What would you do with that money in your respective districts? This is just another perspective to take into consideration while crafting policy to reduce and eventually eradicate gun violence in Pennsylvania. In conclusion, I again want to thank the committee and leadership for having this conversation. Given the makeup of the Commonwealth, we are in a unique position to draft policy and legislation that will have an impact on a diverse set of communities. But something that I will always remember during this discussion as I reflect on the communities I serve, there will always be a teddy bear. It's on us at this time to perpetuate the right meaning for our children. It's on us to take down the shirts outside of Overbrook Presbyterian Church and initiate the blueprint for a safer Pennsylvania, because at the end of the day, it's costing us too much. Thank you.